All right, what is going on YouTube? Today we are doing a Dota 2 Lich guide, as you guys can see right here behind me. And today I really wanted to help you guys with the whole quest idea, because now that the Winter 2016 pass is here, many people are playing as Lich and Dragon Knight, trying to do these challenges. So I have some ideas and some tips for you guys, and so I'm going to walk you through step by step on why I played Lich and how I actually finished the quest and that type of stuff. So first, let's start off by looking at the picks here, and I'll tell you a little bit about what's going on in just a second. So Lich is an intelligence ranged support nuker. He is a support character, and you guys will see I do try to support. Now, you can see there's 10 seconds left in this pick, and they ended up picking up Lone Druid, and I'm not going to spoil it here. They have Ricky, another stealth character, Puck, and then, as you can see, they ended up picking up Broodmother as well. So let's go ahead and end up looking at my player perspective here. Prepare for battle. All right. So one of the first things I really want to explain here is that my buy is a lot different than most people's buys, and you can see here I'm kind of looking at what I want to get. Being a support, I did end up buying the courier, as you guys can see right here. And you can see we do have Ricky up on top. That's going to be the hard lane. So, being Lich, I am going to be going bot, and I ended up buying the Ring of Protection and the Ring of Regen, and you'll see why in a minute. So let's go over the different abilities that Lich actually has. So his first ability is Frost Blast, which will blast the target enemy unit within damaging frost, dealing area of damage and slowing movement and attack rates for 4 seconds. The primary target takes the most damage. Wow. So we have a movement slow here. Very good for a support, and my friend ends up picking up this bounty rune here. My second ability is the auto cast. It creates a shield around the target friendly, which adds armor and slows the attacking units. And I'm gonna tell you guys right here, we ended up trying to fight at the bottom rune, safe lane rune, trying to get an early kill. As you can see, Broodmother is invisible. Obviously, we don't know that, and that's going to be a huge key in this game. Moving on to the third ability, which is actually the ability that I leveled up first, and I would recommend you to level up first as well. I can also make a build online if you really need to see how this works. But because early game, you are kind of squishy and weak, you do need that extra health, and your third ability allows you to sacrifice a friendly creep. So, Broodmother is standing here trying to get as much XP. We have Ursa, which is going to be our tank, and hopefully late carry in game. I do not want to give any spoilers out on how this game goes at all, but they do have Ricky and they do have Broodmother. You can see their health right here. Another thing I want to mention is our ultimate ability, which is part of the quest that I had to do, was get 6 bounces between enemy heroes. So the Chain Frost releases an orb of frost that bounces between nearby enemy units, dealing 10 times, slowing the damaging each time it hits the first target is mini stunned. And we ended up getting first blood. There you go. So you can see right here, we get the earlier Broodmother kill. That's going to be key for Ursa. We're not going to focus too much on what he's doing as far as his build. Because I will tell you right now that Lich is actually really weak to Tiny, Pugna, Shadow Shaman, and Ursa. Now, Ursa being on my team, I don't have to worry about that. And actually, we even get another kill there. So that's 2 kills within 2 minutes. 3 total for our team. And I'm going to end up going and checking this bottom rune, because we do have a regeneration rune right here. So the reason Tiny, Pugna, Shadow Shaman, and Ursa are so powerful against Lich is, if you think about it, they have stuns and abilities that can easily shut down Lich. Shadow Shaman, disable. Ursa can just totally destroy Lich, and his ultimate ability, he takes less damage. You have Tiny, you have Pugna, who's just going to lifesteal for days. We have problems with those heroes. So those are heroes you kind of want to avoid facing or laning with. Now when I say laning, I would say Lich can typically go anywhere. He usually goes off lane. As you guys can see here, I was playing the safe lane, and I ended up moving towards the middle. I am helping push this mid lane though, because I do not want our safe lane creeps to push up too far forward. Back to the whole laning idea. So you have Lich, and he is really strong against pretty much any weak support or person with low armor. For example, we have Meepo. Because there's so many Meepos, like the ice thing is just going to balance between them. The chain frost is just going to balance, and it's not going to be a good time. Another thing I really want to mention is that playing against a Vengeful Spirit, Lich can do pretty good against Vengeful Spirit. Timbersaw, Ricky, Medusa, Drow Ranger. Drow Ranger can get shut down because of the movement speed reduction. However, Drow does end up having the wave that is going to silence you. So you can see we're back here again. There's a Templar Assassin and there is a Blood Mother. And I end up getting this Templar Assassin kill right here, I believe. No, maybe not. I remember that. I was pretty upset about that. So one of the things you really need to realize as playing as a support is you are a support. You need to buy wards, which will bring me to my next point. When you're playing against Ricky and Blood Mother, who are on the same team, we have Ricky here at top. When you're playing against people that have two stealthers, I'd like to think that they're very easy to shut down. And you're going to see that in a minute. I will end up buying wards later this game. Spoiler alert. And that's really going to help shut down Blood Mother. You can see right here, I placed the ward. Blood Mother can now be seen. She's running around. I'm not sure what her plan of attack is right there. You can see that with Lich, you do oftentimes suffer with mana. However, that is a common struggle with most intelligent heroes, especially supports. So I placed another sentry down right there. In a panic, I really wanted to get this kill. And you can see there's Templar Assassin. So I'm level 5 and Templar Assassin's level 3. I'm going to end up trying to get a kill here. Y'all can also see how Bloodmother is suffering with her mana as well. And there we go. We end up picking kills. So now that puts us at 6 kills, or 2 kills. And looking at my character, I have 1 kill and 3 assists, so that's definitely interesting. You can also notice that I did get the Tranquil Boots. That's going to be good for the health regeneration, movement speed, armor, pretty much all that. Unfortunately, because I did not get the Arcane Boots, Ursa may have a little bit of trouble with mana. So we talked about some of the people that Lich might be weak against or he'll be strong against, but I did not mention that when you group up with people, if you have a group of friends or you really just want to pub stomp. Is he going to get this kill right here? There you go. So we're just picking up kills left and right on this lane. And obviously, I don't know if Broodmother doesn't realize we don't have wards here or what's going on, because she's just standing there. Looking at my inventory, though, I do end up have 2 more sentry wards. Can't even talk today. I have 2 more sentry wards really just kind of hanging out in my inventory. That's going to allow me to roam top if I need to and kill Ricky if needed be. If that was needed, right? Needed be meaning that, you know, your team might be suffering and you can go top and gank top as Lich. Now, he's a support, so keep in mind, as usual, I cannot stress that enough. But now, if you're noticing the the build that I'm doing right now. I end up having 3 levels in my Frost Blast, and I have 2 levels in my Sacrifice. 1 in my Chain Frost. We're going to have Ursa try and take an early Roshan. He's got Vladimir's Offering. I'm going to kind of be here and just help out a little bit as much as I can. If we look back on bot, you can see they are pushing up a little bit. However, they are missing Templar Assassin. So. Oh. There's Templar Assassin, level 3, and then I'm level 7. So this is obviously a huge problem. I end up getting that bounty. And then they end up having a courier right there too. So they brought up their courier all the way into our tower. Now they did end up destroying our tower, allowing them more room. And that's something you don't want to do when you're playing against people like Ricky or Broodmother, Bounty Hunter. You do not want to give them space. You don't want to give anybody space, to be honest. Because now she can roam further down into the lane. And when I do get this kill, I'm just making sure I actually end up probably kill-stealing a little bit there. As far as this goes, Broodmother can control her spiders. That's another thing you want to watch out for. Dire's middle tower is under attack. Because people tend to run whenever you use your ultimate, and we'll go more in depth in this hopefully later in this video, because I think there are some very good examples of this happening. But because people tend to run whenever they see Lich's ultimate, if you have not seen it, or you know what I'm talking about, how it bounces back and forth, your teammates can be a huge help with this. With that being said, some people you want to keep in mind are Faceless Void's Chronosphere. That's a good ultimate. We have 2 of them actually right here on bot. So we have Faceless Void's Chronosphere, can be a huge help. Enigma has a couple good abilities. And as you see, I use my ultimate right here and they are running. So I ended up getting the Broodmother kill. Now I'm blocked by the spiders from Broodmother. And I'm heading bot, hoping to get this Templar Assassin kill. Templar Assassin, I can look at her inventory and know that she only has the power treads. Now, another thing you don't want to do is you do not want to be greedy when it comes to these things. I probably could have turned around and got that kill there if I wanted to, but you'll see how this all plays out. So really, even Magnus can be a good duo or help out in laning group fights and team fights with Lich, because the more people you can get within that like circle, the more congested you can get a lane, the more you can hit with your ultimate. And that's going to be a really major key when it comes to late game. So right now I am building Tranquil Boots. And you see I have the Staff of Wizardry and I also have the Aura Club. Now you probably know I am rushing Aghrim Scepter because I am doing this challenge. Aghrim Scepter isn't too bad of an item. For Lich, it makes it so the ice can infinitely hit other heroes. Sorry, I'm trying to figure out. Because I at the time I was communicating, I was in a party with a couple people, and so I did want to communicate a little bit. Another thing you can notice here is that Lone Druid actually quit. That's 11 minutes into the game. Lone Druid, 0 kills, 0 deaths, 0 assists. I haven't seen much with him as far as right now. And we do end up pushing that bottom tower. You really want to watch out. This game I didn't have to worry too much because I had Ursa there and I could escape or slow him down if I needed to. I did want Ursa to pick up that invisibility though. Now having Ursa and Tiny on the same team, I'm not going to say we didn't have the best picks, but we also didn't have the worst picks. Keep in mind this is actually an unranked match. Just really wanted to get this over with, but keep in mind that with the quest, you actually have to win the match for the winter pass. They have to win the match for in order for it to work. And that can be difficult.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
So far our team is actually doing pretty good. I can show some game stats here. You can kind of see everybody's kill and death assist ratio. And we are going to end up getting that tower. Now, if you notice, here's something I noticed. And I'm glad I noticed it when I did notice it. Look who we have on top. We have Broodmother on top. We also have Templar Assassin. And as you can tell, Puck actually was removed from the game due to added activity and will be assessed with an abandon. Templar Assassin and Broodmother right here. There's one kill.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
And see, I should have placed wards there. Possibly. I could have got that Templar Assassin kill. We do have Ricky at mid, though. And that was a brilliant escape from Tiny right there. But can he make it? So top lane, we're back up here again. There's three of us now. And we are going to be pushing this top lane. Now they are teleporting, and this is a 1-on-3 advantage here. Broodmother does place her webs. But as I said early, Broodmother and Ricky are kind of really easy to shut down. If you check my inventory, I do not have any wards. That was my mistake. But, as you can tell, I'm not the only one that made a mistake here. Me and Broodmother are both level 9, Rookie's level 7. Broodmother pops out of stealth. I got the dominating kill. And then Ricky is also trying to take on a 1-on-3. And that's going to leave us with 17 kills to us and 4 kills for them. Another thing I really want to notice, show you guys really, is XP per minute. If you look at the XP per minute, I'm currently getting 371 XP a minute. Ursa's getting 389. This is going to change later on in the game. And as the game continues, people are going to build differently. I'm going to build differently. And if you look right here, I did buy Observer and Sentry Wards, and I also bought Agrim Scepter. So, look right there. So I only have two items. Now, I could have easily bought some other items, like some iron branches or chainmail or something. But at this time, I felt like I didn't need it. That's going to be a huge part. I say that a lot when I commentate now over this. I think that's going to be a major role playing Dota. Just in general, you have to be aware of your surroundings. Be aware of the enemy team. Now, me knowing the enemy team, I know they have Templar Assassin, Broodmother, Ricky, Lone Druid, and Puck. Now, Puck's going to be a support. I haven't even seen too much from him this game. He only has one death. However, Rookie has 5 deaths. And Rookie can actually, with the new updates have been the Rookie, I don't know, I wouldn't want to say he's nerfed, because I've seen some people still do really good with Rookie. I'm just running around and placing wards here. So, getting that regeneration rune. I think my teammate might be getting it. Templar Assassin is here though, and I'm going to be slowing down her movement speed, which allows Ursa to catch up using his phase boots, getting the kill, and the regeneration rune. I mean, it's pretty self-explanatory, my XP per minute is going down, but if we end up looking at current gold, I have 575 gold, I'm spending a lot of it. Net worth, on the other hand, I'm third in net worth with 5,961. Increasing as we go. And last hits and denies. Not really too big of a deal, just some other stats I could give you guys. But our courier does end up dying. Now our courier dies right here because of Broodmother. And we all know that, so I'm going to see if I can come up from behind. And we have Ursa and Org Magi right there. And check this out. Oh. Broodmother comes up and around. Right here. There we go. setting the webs. I do not have any wards placed here. And then I can see Ancient Apparition come here, and they get the kill. Now,
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Thought they got a kill. No? Okay. So this game was actually earlier today, a couple hours ago. I had to do some stuff, and then I figured I would record it and help you guys out. Hopefully this is helping you guys out. You can look now at my build. The ice armor, I'm really building last. I don't feel like I need it. I'm really using the sacrifice ability. You'll see me use it a couple times throughout the game. I do not use it as much as I should have. Chain Frost, I also don't use that as much as I should have either. Templar Assassin's running up middle. I'm level 11. Templar Assassin's level 6. Going invisible.
Dire's middle tower has fallen. Dire's top tower is under attack.
Another thing you could do with Lich, I've actually seen some people buy phase boots with it. If you really want to gank and use your ultimate ability, and that would be great. You can actually do really well with Lich, with phase boots. So you might see people build that way. Personally, Tranquil Boots is my favorite. And you're going to see Ursa end up camping. There's my ultimate right there. So let's see if we can get that kill. I got the mega kill streak. Templar Assassin's invisible. But I don't have any wards. So I always try to keep wards on me when I'm playing support. Because you never know what's going to happen. And then Puck is going to die right here too. Got unstoppable kill streak. If you guys check right here, I'm going 6 kills and 0 deaths with 8 assists. That's really good. Ursa is going to be kind of roaming around bot lane. He's also trying to do the Roshan. He needs to do it 3 times for his quest. And you're going to see me. I'm going to be making a couple, I could say, bad purchases with Lich. And you're going to learn from that. I don't even get to finish it. Because it's just, it was bad. So Ricky, Templar Assassin, and they bring their courier up. Now I'm standing here and I'm really kind of curious, like, what else is there to buy? I got my Agrim Scepter, I've got almost 3,000 gold. I mean, I can solo these people pretty easily. But, just to kind of see how things would work out. Right there, so we end up getting the double kill. And then, Ancient Appreciation gets the third kill. I'm low on mana, as we talked about before. Now I'm getting the Mystic Staff. Now here's something. Probably show you guys. Heart of Tarrasque. With giving the 40 strength and 300 health. Most people don't get harder to rask as Lich or really any support. I forget I have like the face cam on, so I'm just not even like looking at you guys. I'm sorry. Most people don't. Personally, because of us being in their base, and we're going to actually camp in their base for a while because we need to destroy these towers. We're trying to finish the quest. And at this point, I have not finished the quest. And you will see when I do. So I'm currently trying to kind of block this creep wave. We have those two towers there. I'm waiting for my teammates. We can all push. And then Broodmother ends up dying again. And you just see this. I've had a couple clutch plays. Just rather than not die, I'm just making bad predictions here. So unfortunately, we don't really have any heals in our team. And again, I'm saying this as if we had... I'm trying to think now. If we had Faceless Void, That'd be a really good combination. And you really just need to stay out of the Chronosphere. So that's something to keep in mind if you're going to lane with Chronosphere. So easily right here, another mistake by Breadmother, trying to defend. I end up getting the kill. Now I'm getting more gold. And this courier is just chilling here back at our spawn. Now here's something else that's kind of interesting. If you watch what I do right here, I use my ultimate, and it ends up giving me that double kill. So now, I got a double kill with that ultimate. If you saw that, it went back and forth and back and forth. Lone Druid and Ricky. So you're going to see it too. I end up buying Shiva's Guard. Now, couple reasons for that. Let's kind of look at what Shiva's Guard does. So it has 30 intelligence. That's going to help a lot, considering I have 57 plus 35 right now. I'll do the calculations in your head. And then 15 armor as well. I have 5 armor plus 13. 15 armor can be very good. Now, the active can emit a freezing wave that deals 200 magic damage to enemies and slows their movement speed by 4 seconds. Let's look on their team and see who has a lot of movement speed. Templar Assassin, Ricky, Broodmother. I'm gonna end up teleporting back mid. I got my Shiva's Guard. I got what I need right now. And then obviously it reduces the attack speed of all enemies in a 900 radius. Again, Templar Assassin, Ricky, Broodmother, Lone Druid. So it was a good item. Just think about, I guess, the enemy team when you're purchasing this. Now our team's kind of just chilling here. They're defending because we have the super melee creeps.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
So surprisingly enough, I'm actually now kind of a tanky support, and I'm going to end up getting this Broodmother kill. You're going to see Broodmother's trying to lifesteal. Alright, she has the health regeneration. XP per minute. I'm actually second for XP per minute now. Have 447 XP per minute, and that's going to continue to increase as the game goes on. Now, usually I probably would have stayed on the laning on the bottom, or safe lane, hard lane, whatever you're going, off lane phase, until level 11. Now, I'm only level 14, and I've been out of that lane for a long period of time. So there is a laning phase to this, and I actually ended that quite early. Templar Assassin just hanging out here. Again, I don't have any awards. I had all this gold, and I didn't buy the awards. I could have bought them. I didn't feel like I needed them. And now they brought us awards. We get a kill there. Look who's here. Broodmother's here. What do you know?
Dire's middle tower has fallen.
So we're really just trying to take these towers out. Ursa's trying to do his challenge. I'm leading with close to 500 XP a minute. Gold per minute. We're almost tied. So Ricky is here. He's level 9 and he's trying to take on a level 15 support. Now Ricky's job is probably to take out some of the supports. And by taking out some of the supports can help in team fights and stuff like that. Or just trying like ganking and everything. Now we have Templar Assassin right here. Going invisible. I don't have any awards again because I already used them. Now I end up running in there to see who's in there. They pulled Puck out. Templar Assassin right here. Can Templar Assassin get the kill on me? I'll let you guys decide that. Boom. Turned around. My teammate was lucky there, lucky enough to help me. And you can see that the Ancient is under attack, and that will be ending the game. 40 kills to 7 kills. Hopefully this helped you out. Please give me tips and feedback. I can always improve and help you guys out if you have any questions playing Lich. But I do usually main support. It varies, but you can see that here is our team right here. And of course the final stats, but we did pretty good. The other team, I feel like they didn't try the hardest. The game ended in 27 minutes. That was pretty quick. I mean, I ended the game at level 16. Unfortunately, I didn't get to show you guys the full leveling all the way to level 25, because that could have been a little bit different. But please like the video if you enjoyed, and I will see you guys in my next video. Later.